Welcome back to the channel. I hope you've all been having a fabulous week. This week's video is my Q&A. I've been teasing this for a long time on Instagram, if you follow me there. If you don't, here's the handle. But I've been teasing for a while on Instagram that I'm gonna be doing this Q&A video on my YouTube channel, and I keep pushing it off for some reason. It just like never happens when I want it to, or when I'm gonna do it one week, suddenly I have an idea for another video, and it just like never happens. So this week is finally the week I'm doing the Q&A video. So a few weeks ago I asked on Instagram if you guys had any personal questions for me, or business related questions, or photography questions, or anything. Basically anything. You could ask me anything. You guys really delivered with a bunch of great questions, so I am going to get to answering some of them right now. So the first question is going to be an easy one. Someone asked me, how old are you? I am 26 years old. I'm going to be 27 next month, so 27. What is your full-time job and how did you start the job search process? This one's a little hard for me to answer because currently I'm actually unemployed because of COVID. So what I did before COVID, so I was a creative at a media production company. We worked with making advertisements. In terms of the job search process, I can't necessarily tell you much about that because the company actually approached me about the job, so I didn't actually go searching for it. I wasn't actually thinking about doing that kind of job at all until I was approached, and then I was like, hey, this actually might be something I'm interested in doing. But in terms of searching for a job, I would say put yourself out there, make a portfolio of all of your work so that you can show the company you're interested in working with, your work and everything you've done, and basically show off your skills, and then just reach out. Reach out, put your resume out there, send people emails, see what happens. Some might bite, some might not, but that's okay. Start there, start looking at companies you love and move on from there. So, okay, another fun question. Someone asked, what are my plans for my free canoe that I got? So back in March or April, I got a free canoe. Someone, a neighbor, just had a canoe out with a sign that said free on it, and I said it was gonna be my quarantine project and that I was gonna repaint it and everything. It's like white and powder blue right now. It's not very pretty. So I thought I would like paint it and make it look all nice. I admit I haven't done that yet, but that is still the plan, to paint it green and black probably. Probably the seats and the edge are gonna be black. The whole canoe is gonna be green and then like a cream on the inside. So that's my plan. Okay, so next question I thought was amazing was, is your feed curated or does it reflect your real life? So my Instagram feed, is it more curated? Or is it actually a reflection of my real life? And it would be the latter. It is actually a reflection of my real life. So my style, I would call more documentary-like style. So yes, my feed, my Instagram feed, my YouTube channel, my blog, what am I interested in at the moment? What am I doing? What am I excited about? What am I thinking of? All that sort of thing, I do post about that. That is the content that I do, because that's what interests me. I do consider my Instagram still a personal Instagram, even though it does function like a business for me, but it is still a personal Instagram because it is a reflection of my life, who I am, what I'm doing at this moment, and I'm actually really proud of that because I don't just set up, you know, a shot with hot chocolate and some cookies and it looks really cozy and cute in the winter or whatever, and then just take it down when I'm done. And lots of people do that, but I don't, because I'm like, you know what, I want some hot chocolate and a cookie. And guess what? I can take a photo of it while I'm at it. And so I'll make myself hot chocolate and a cookie, I'll take a photo, and then I'm gonna sit down, enjoy it, and you know, answer emails or whatever while I enjoy my hot chocolate and a cookie. So I use what was in my life to create content. Oh, this is a good one. How to deal with negativity and online bullying. This one's interesting because I really haven't had any real bullying or negativity online. I've been very blessed and fortunate about that. But I will say that the Instagram culture, the social media culture, everything has gotten worse since COVID. And I think everyone has just been very on edge, and it makes people say things before really thinking about them. But I will say you have to really think about what you say first. I have experienced a few things on Instagram. People message me and they're not very nice, you know, and it is hard to deal with that, but you have to also be the bigger person. You have to take the higher road when it comes to negativity. You can't fight back. just don't do it. You know, bullies, if someone is truly a bully, they are gonna want you to fight them because that's what they enjoy. They enjoy the confrontation, they enjoy the fight. If you just ignore them, they'll eventually leave you alone. So just ignore them. Just ignore any online negativity. And honestly, that's gonna be so much better for your mental health if you're just pushing everything away and being like, I'm not even gonna deal with that. I'm not even gonna make mental space to think about that. Like, that's not happening. And so if you see something, if you see a message that comes through a message request on Instagram, say, and it starts off pretty negative or it looks like it's heading in that way, just delete it. Delete it right away. You don't need to look at it. Don't read the whole thing. You do not need to read the whole thing. Just delete it. Put it away. Put it out of your mind. It is not something that you have to deal with. It is their problem, not yours. It's actually really sad because I had like a good connection with them. Like they would say something mean or hurtful, or they're trying to be control my life, or they're trying to be mean to me or hurt me in some way. And the sad thing is I look back at our previous messages and they've always been so kind and so nice, and they're just having a bad day. But guess what? It's not okay to have a bad day and take it out on innocent people around you, even if you disagree with what they're saying or what they're doing at the time. It's not okay to take your personal bad day and put it on somebody else, to shame them or make them unhappy or make them sad or just hurt them to make yourself feel better, because that honestly doesn't make you feel better. And the sad thing is, those people who I had a good relationship with on social media, we had messaged before, we had been so nice, and I had to block them. The fact that they could have said something nice, and maybe they are genuinely a nice person, but they had a bad day, were mean, the consequences, you get blocked. The consequences, you can no longer follow that person that maybe you like to follow. That is a consequence. That's not good. It's one strike and you're out. Even if they're a nice person normally, if they're gonna have bad days and take it out on you, then they don't need to be following you and you can block them. I highly, highly recommend the block button. It is a very good tool and will really help your mental health if you suffer from getting people harassing you or bullying you or online trolls. Block them, take them out of your life. You do not need to deal with them. They need to figure their own stuff out. It's not for you to do. When and why did you start blogging? I have had a blog. It's getting a little bright. I feel like I have had a blog on and off again for 10 years, maybe. Might be around 10 years. I think my first blog was like vintage fashion, and then it moved on from there to be more a New England style blog. And since then it's evolved to be more of a personal blog that has to do more with travel, travel guides, fashion, lifestyle content. That's really where my blog has grown into. And so off and on, I've had blogs for like, I think 10 years now. But I think the reason I start blogging is just I had some things to share, and that's why I think everyone should start blogging. If you have something to share, share it. That's as simple as that. What is your favorite nail polish color?
What is your name?
My name is Sir Lancelot of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is your favorite color?
What is your favorite nail polish color? This is something I kind of want to address because I apologize, I do not have a favorite nail polish color. Something that is a common misconception with me, and I'm not exactly sure why, is that I'm like high maintenance in terms of like my hair and my nails and my makeup and my clothes and everything. And I don't know if it's because I have like my own sense of style or something and I really appreciate fashion that people have sort of like thought this about me, but I'm probably like one of the most low maintenance people. I mean, I keep my makeup super natural. I buy it all from CVS, but yes, I don't want to splurge on makeup, so I buy all my makeup from CVS. I keep it as natural as possible. I mean, I've got a messy bun today. This is like a quick messy bun. I don't dye my hair. I hardly ever get it cut. I'm pretty low maintenance. I don't treat myself. As you can see, I cut my fingernails very, very short. They're never long. I don't paint them, ever. I paint my toenails maybe once in a while. And if I do, it's just like a random color I see that I like and I'll grab it and I'll paint them that color. So I'm sorry, I don't have a good nail polish color and I'm really very low maintenance altogether, all across the board. How did you get into travel blogging? And I think it had to do from just being in New England. Everything here is so, there's just beauty and nature everywhere. And there's so many cute little towns and so many great cities, so many places to eat and adorable shops and the coastline of Maine and Nantucket. And then you've got the White Mountains in New Hampshire. There's just so much diversity and beauty in nature here that and also all the states are really small and very close together that I just naturally tended to travel around doing day trips. And from there, that sort of moved on to traveling more to England and Scotland, and I've done Switzerland and Germany, and I've gone to, I think, 9 countries now? I think it's 9 countries. And I want to see more. I just love it. I love documenting my travels. I love sharing them. I love sharing recommendations. This is just something that I love. I love photographing beautiful landscapes. I love photographing quaint villages and little towns, and that's just something I am really passionate about. I'm passionate about documenting, and so I think that's just sort of, it grew from just traveling around New England a lot, and it just sort of grew from there, and that's when I realized, like, I actually love the travel aspect of my Instagram and my blog, and I wanted to do more. Now, do you ever miss the West Coast? Okay. No. So I'll give you a little backstory if you don't know it. I actually was born and raised in California, Southern California, and I lived there until I was 14 years old, and then my family moved across the country to New Hampshire for my dad's job, and so I've lived here almost half my life now, which is pretty crazy to think about. Do I miss the West Coast? Yes. But I wouldn't necessarily say it's just the West Coast in general, it's just the West in general I miss. I love it here in New England. I love the seasons. I love the beautiful landscapes. I love how close everything is. All the states are like really small, so everything's really close. I mean, I'm 4 hours from New York City. I'm 1 hour and 20 minutes from Boston. You know, Vermont's right next door. Maine's right next door. I'm 4 hours, I think, from Quebec. And like, I don't know, maybe 3.5 hours from the Canadian border. So there's a lot here. New England has so much to offer, and it's just so beautiful, and I love the seasons. I love how each season is different, and I did not get that in California. In California, in Southern California, it was basically, honestly, summer weather all year round. Yeah, so Southern California, do I miss it? I miss some aspects of it. I miss friends and family for sure. I miss the mountains. I miss a lot of it. But in general, I would say I just miss the West more. I don't know, I just miss the desert sometimes, lots of the time. I miss the desert. I miss like big expanses and plateaus and mesas. I miss Zion National Park in Utah. That was my favorite trip that I ever did, was to Zion. I was really hoping this September to get back there, but that's not happening. So maybe, hopefully, fingers crossed, next year I'll be doing that trip. But I just, yeah, I miss the vast, huge landscape. I miss the big sky. I miss the giant mountain. I miss the desert. I miss the dirt sometimes. Hi, buddy. Carson's right here. Hi, buddy. Oh, puppy. Yeah, so I do miss the West Coast a lot. I miss the West. It's so beautiful out there. And would I consider moving there again someday? Probably. I would. I think I could. I think I could do it. And I think I would like it. But at the moment, I don't really have any plans to move there. I'm enjoying myself in New England just fine. So I'll be here for the foreseeable future for sure. How? What are you whining about? This little buddy. What are your plans and goals for your business and your business growth? I have a lot of plans. Sort of everything's sort of on the back burner at the moment because of COVID. So my big plan was that in 2021, I was gonna start hosting group trips, probably in New England and places in the US, and from there expanding to places possibly around the world. So that was my 2021 plan. And then I was going to be sort of prepping for it and doing a few trips where I could take like content, photos, and things to do promotion for the group trips. Buddy. This year, that was the plan, and then COVID hit, and so everything's sort of put on the back burner. I think I definitely am going to still, I'm planning in the future to be doing group trips, but it might be pushed off for one more year. We'll just sort of see what 2021 holds when we get there, but I'm definitely, that is the big plan, is to be starting to host group trips to places across the US and then eventually around the world. It'll probably be all female trips, And a big goal with these trips, I think, would be to make it a lot about adventure and pushing past fear and being more adventurous, and just for women to like be together, encouraging each other to put themselves out there, to be adventurous and to face their fears. And I think that's so powerful. I have experienced that in my life where I've pushed myself and I have made such amazing memories because of it. And it's been some of the most incredible stuff I've ever been able to do, is because I pushed past a fear. And I just want other people to experience that. So I thought it'd be really fun to host group trips that are all women, and we can encourage each other and all be there for each other and push each other to be better, to do better, to be more adventurous, and to have fun and make amazing memories because of it. So that's my goal. Maybe coming in 2021, but probably being pushed off for another year, but we'll see. I don't know. So sometime, hopefully in the near future, I will be hosting group trips. Okay, so this is going to be the last question of the day. And that question is, where'd it go? Okay, so this will be the last question, and it is, how did you start out? Basics of what you bought to start. So with this question, I believe what they're talking about is start off blogging, Instagramming, my business and everything, and what sort of equipment I needed to start that. In all honesty, you don't really need much. Lots of people just shoot with an iPhone when they're taking photos. So you can just do that. So there's a lot you can do with photography with your phone. And then there's a lot of great editing apps like Visco and Snapseed. And then if you download the free Lightroom app, you can buy mobile presets. You can edit your photos in there. I'll have some links to my presets below for you if you want to check that out. And so they're great ways to make your photos, if they're just on an iPhone, look amazing. And the way with the iPhone technology and the camera technology now on iPhones is super incredible. So you can do a lot with your iPhone. So honestly, if you really want to start out now, just do it, even if you don't have a nice camera, and then just start with your iPhone. But what I really did to start, the equipment I used, I bought what I'm filming on right now, which is my Canon EOS 6D Mark II. It's been really great, and I bought it specifically because it has a flip out screen. So right now I can see myself, because it's the camera's facing me, but the screen flips out so that I can see what's going on. So I knew it would be good for getting video. So that was the reason I bought the 6D Mark II. I usually have my 50mm on here, but right now I have the 16-35 2.8 on lens on my camera right now. And so that's more of a wide angle lens. This one I'm actually borrowing at the moment. I don't own this, but it is something that I'm using to see if I like it and if it's something I want to invest in the future. But I actually have the really cheap 50mm lens that's like $150. That's a Canon lens. But it's been a great investment, and it takes like really beautiful photos because it goes down to a 1.8 aperture. Really beautiful, beautiful photos. I highly recommend that lens, especially if you're starting out, because it's affordable and very good for the price. And also, the first thing I did actually before I got this camera, because I was shooting on the Canon 40D, I think. I believe it was the Canon 40D I was shooting on first, and it didn't actually do video. So what I did at the beginning was I shot with the 40D that I already had, and I bought a GoPro. So anytime I wanted to take video, I would use the GoPro. So yeah, honestly, starting out small with a GoPro and iPhone is a great way to start out with a YouTube channel or just an Instagram, and then you can work your way up from there. I recommend the Canon 6D Mark II with a 50mm lens to start out. I think that's a really great, affordable way to start out. All right, so that's all of the questions, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. That is it for today's video. I will see you guys next week. Don't forget to comment below, like this video, and subscribe if you have not. I will see you all next week. Bye!